that, man. I don't mind. Well, had a chance to go to the Music Awards, and I was in hope of getting a chance to meet Eminem. I had KJ City with me, yours, and Lord opened up the door for me to be able to meet him. It was after he had won an award. He was backstage with his bodyguards around him, and they were pretty much keeping people away from him.
Dear Slim, I wrote you, but you still ain't calling. It's been like 3 years since I wrote that song, and a lot has changed now for you and I. I had no clue that I would write a song for you and it would change my life. Kids with tears in their eyes still come up to me, showing love to me and telling me that they look up to me. The strangest thing I've seen recently has come to be that I'd get dissed for saying what Jesus done for me. It's a whole other side of things that I come to see. Still a huge influence you got upon this industry. But enough for me, cause it's not what I came to say to you. I still try to take the time every day to pray for you. Sorry now for what your mom and daddy did to you, but a lot of kids relate with you, cause really they've been there too. I know there's a lot of pain and hurt now that you've been through, but it's still a real love that God has gave for you.
I just kind of prayed and I said, God, you know, give me the opportunity to give him this CD. And I had a chance to walk up to him and I said, hey Eminem, you don't know me, but you know that song Dear Stan you did? He said, yeah. And I said, well, there's a guy that's written a song to you kind of based the same way. I said, it's called Dear Slim. He said, what is he doing, dissing me?
Yo.
I said,
no. Dear Slim, I wrote you, but you still ain't calling. I met the guy who backstage gave you my song, and I still wondering what you thought, man, when he walked up to you and talked to you and left the CD in your hands. You might have listened to it or you might have lost it. Some say you heard it, probably got mad and tossed it.
Well, did he hit you back?
Well, that's the question that I always get, but I know your wife has heard it, and at least I know that she liked it. Congratulations on your movie, yo. I heard your record sales like over 20 million sold. But there's one thing that's really got me thinking, bro. Does a Grammy mean anything if it's just gotta cost your soul? I thank God for the love that never goes away. I was going to hell, but it didn't have to be that way. You see, the bottom line of what I always say is God puts back together broken pieces that been thrown away. Everyone you know just up and goes away. He'll still love you to the very day that you're old and gray. There's still a lot of Christians, all they do is hate on you instead of dropping their knees and taking time to pray for you. It's obvious that you really love your daughter, dude. For that I gotta say, well, got respect for you. But here it is, Dear Slim, chapter part 2. Another cat still trying to make it, just like you.
Nah, man, I said, actually, it's the opposite. He's actually showing you a lot of respect and love. And I said, this is a message of hope that he's given you. And I said, if you don't mind, I would like to give you one of these CDs that he's done. And he said, man, I'll take it. And he took it, and we sat there and talked just a little bit more. Thing is, I don't know if he ever heard it or not.
Dear Slim, hear the junk that I'm going through? MTV's hating on me, saying that I'm biting you. VH1 jumped in and started ripping on me too. It's so obvious, they seem to get my song confused. And I'll admit what I say could sound funny, but I never came at you just to paint you as the enemy. I was never hating you and starting controversy. I was never blaming you and trying to make some money. See, I don't claim to know everything that you've experienced. I guess by now, well, you've already been having this. But in my life, there's one thing I hold is this, is that a life without Christ is still a life that is never fixed. I'll admit it's a hard pill to swallow that you and I these days will always be the role models. You see these kids, we're the ones they always follow. What we saying, how we live gives them a better tomorrow. I had my Sarasavo, plus man I've been rejected. I've been chewed up, spit out and plus disrespected. But if I die today and I never set another record, Jesus gave me more than I ever could have been expecting. Life is hectic, it can leave you blown away. But check it, bro, man, we all just gonna die someday. And on that note, well, there's one thing left to say, is that it's still one love and one God and only one way.
One way.
I said, he's showing you a lot of respect, a lot of love. I said, this is a message from God to you through him. And I said, I'm just asking, will you please take it and just listen to it? And he said, yeah, I'll take it. So he took it from my hand, and I prayed, and I said, God, use this right now. Bless this moment to encourage Eminem into a relationship with you.
One sec.
Go ahead.